In this problem, we're going to deal with heat conduction along a wire. Just like you saw in the unit, we're going to split the wire that we have into discrete chunks. In fact, we're going to split it into 100 different chunks, numbered from 0 to 99. We can then measure the temperature of each chunk and label that with a proper number. So for example, the temperature in the last chunk is going to be labeled T99. As you already heard from Jorn, the temperature in any given segment, let's take the eighth segment for example, depends on the temperature in the surrounding two segments. Any segments that are touching one another are going to feed energy into each other. So the seventh and ninth segments can both feed energy into the eighth. In the same way, the eighth segment is going to feed energy into both the seventh and the ninth segments. To express the temperature of the eighth segment after a time step, then, we can use the finite difference scheme to come up with this equation right here. This equation tells us that the temperature after the time step, right here, is equal to the temperature before the time step plus this term, which we can see depends on the initial temperatures of the seventh, ninth, and eighth segments. This is obviously an explicit method for calculating T8 at time h. But just for a change of pace, since this is a pretty unstable solution, we're going to try an implicit method instead. Remember that implicit means that you're going to have this term over on this side as well. So we're just going to switch all of these zeros to h's. You're going to use this implicit method, of course converting it to code, in this problem. One problem that we have to deal with is how to handle the segments on either end of our wire. Both of these have an adjacent segment to one direction, but not to the other. Since our segments start at 0 and count up to 99, our problem more explicitly is that we don't have a segment numbered -1, nor a segment numbered 100. To deal with this, we're just going to set the value of T-1 to equal T0, and similarly for T100, setting that to T99. This is going to be true for all times T. Your main job in this problem is going to be to find the coefficients for every equation in this set of equations right here. Each equation involves an expression, which is just a sum of all the different temperatures of every segment, along with some coefficients stuck in front of certain ones, and all of this equals the initial temperature at that certain segment. This means that we have a set of 100 different equations. When we consider the system of equations as a whole, we can actually think of it more conveniently as dealing with matrices. This method right here, numpy.matalloc.solve, deals with equations involving matrices. We have a matrix of the coefficients, which are all of these pink question marks, multiplied by a single column vector, which contains all of the temperatures after time step h. These multiplied together equals this vector, which contains all of the initial values of the temperatures. Since we already know the temperatures at time 0, and you will have created a matrix of coefficients, we can use this method, numpy.matalloc.solve, and input the known information and solve for the vector that we want, the one containing the temperatures after time step h. Taking a look at our supplied code, you can see that we've created an initial temperature distribution for you. We've also created a parameter for you called C, which I think if you look back at the finite difference formula, you'll see is going to be very useful for you. As I told you earlier, your first task is going to be to fill in the array named coefficients with the appropriate values. Remember, a lot of the coefficients will be zero. Another hint that I want to give you is that using for loops could be a great way to fill in the coefficients to all their different slots in the matrix. Once coefficients is filled in, come back up to the step size and set it to 0.5 when you submit. In the end, you should have a curve that looks nice and smooth like this, despite the pretty large step size that we're going to be using.